Buonasera, welcome to this beautiful synagogue of Vercelli. We are Ashkenaz Trio. We're playing for you tonight. We're from Israel and Germany, and we're playing East European and German Jewish music for you. The next song is an East European tune, and it's a love declaration to the city of Odessa.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
of songs where people cannot come together. So this is another one, the two are in love, but they can't come together. So they're writing letters, so that's why the song is called Papier ist weiß. So paper is white and ink.
Die Gleichheit nicht sitzig in
Do you want to join us singing? Do you want to try something? Yeah, so I'm going to sing a melody, and we try this together, and when we play the song, maybe you can join us, okay? So this is the melody.
Thank you. Yeah. through to make something. You know that everybody knows about Niccolò Paganini, right? It's like your Italian guy, beautiful violin as well. Composed very complicated pieces for violin. And there's legend about Paganini, so somebody breaks his strings, so he should play only on the one string G, and he made it beautifully, and even he composed several things, several pieces for G string only. So, but even Paganini needed a bow to play one string, right? Because you can't play violin without a bow. So this next piece, I will play without a bow. Now I just need to make something additional to the power. So you need to play with how to play violin without a bow. You need only one hair, a horse hair, what you have in the bow. But so basically this piece called "What Should You Do If You Play on the Wedding and Somebody Stole Your Bow?" Your bow was stolen. So you make one horse hair on your violin so you can play without a good beat. Okay. It's not really a Jewish trick because we are not stealing one bow in the wedding. So but I know because I played a lot of Roma musicians, so I know this trick from them. GM. Thank you.
certain words to it. So it's originally probably a German song, and we found a Yiddish version of the song, so we will play the Yiddish and the German version of one. It's a song about the World War I experience. So it's blacksmith who has to go to war for the German or the Austrian army, probably. And he says goodbye to his family. And the mother says that the young girl, his daughter, should pray for him. And as you can maybe already guess, Kaddish is a prayer that's also said, like, in remembering those who died. So, in Judaism. So, he's not coming back. And in this case, the daughter then probably says the Kaddish. So, Kaddish, the Yiddish of Soldat.
Mas
say some words. Just have to find the lyrics in a second. Because we changed the order of the songs. Now, here it is. Okay, so as you can imagine, all these songs were sung and written in a certain historic context. Yeah? So, for example, this next song is probably from the 20s, 30s, about the movement of Jews going to Israel, yeah? And the first song about Odessa was a song that probably Ukrainian Jews sang when they were maybe in the States, in New York, and they remembered Odessa, okay? So it's very interesting what context this song has. Now, if I sing these songs to you today, of course, at least for me, there's another resonance, because there's war in the Ukraine today, and there's no peace in the Middle East and for Israel today, right? So, at least me personally, I would wish for peace for the Ukraine and for Israel and the Middle East, okay? So let's have this in mind. He didn't say anything. Shabbos, so yesterday you would sing this. And, well, it's the beginning of the week, so in a way, it's still okay to sing it now. Agundavo, so good week. Was er verdammt, noch sein